So I literally just...
Oh yeah, it's time to get fancy. My name is Jochen, I am a Power Platform Consultant at Sigeka, and in today's video I'm gonna show you guys how simple it is to create overlays and pop-ups to fancy up your Power App. Let's go! Hey guys, and welcome back to this Powerapps beginner series where I am creating my office ordering supplies app from scratch. Throughout all the episodes, I'm showing you a lot of building blocks that you can use to create your own stuff in Powerapps. So if you have missed an episode or you simply want to start at the very beginning, there is a link to the whole playlist down in the video description. Don't hesitate to check it out. But if you are just here for today's fancy stuff, that's also fine because we're gonna kick it off by creating a loading overlay. Now, without any doubt, you have seen this before on a website or on an application on your phone. If you, for example, load up the first screen, you get a loading overlay which kind of prevents you from clicking anything. That is exactly what we are going to build inside our own app. And I want to create this for starters on my home screen. If I go to the unvisible property, you can see that we put in two lines of code last episode. Now these two lines of code kinda do a data refresh, and depending on the amount of data, this could take a couple of seconds. Now the question is, do we want the user to start clicking around while that is happening, or do we simply want them to wait? I would suggest option B, and that is exactly what we can achieve by building a loading overlay, so let's do it. And it's very simple. It will just be two controls, a rectangle and a label. So let's start by adding those. Rectangle first, and then a text label. I'm just going to rename them as well. And let's start with the rectangle. Right now, by default, because that's my theme, this has the orange color, but I don't really want that. So I'm going to go to the fill property and say, instead of this value, 255.255.255.0.9, which is the alpha value again, and it's kind of the transparency. And this is what happens. So you can recreate that typical overlay look simply by using this color in your fill property for a simple rectangle. Second part of the overlay is the label. So let's make this also the full size of our screen. Central alignment, let's go for, I don't know, 30. And then of course we want it to say, between double quotes, loading dot dot dot. And let's make this even bigger. Let's go for 75. There we go. And final step for now, I'm gonna group these two controls together by holding down control and selecting them, right click or hit the three dots, group, and rename the group to group loading HS. And that, my friends, is pretty much all it takes to create an overlay. But of course, as you can see, we have an issue now, because at this moment, this will always be visible. If I go to the visible property of this group, by default, it is set to true, AKA always show this, which is obviously not what we want. So let's change that, because instead of saying true or false for a visible property, we can also use a variable, for example. Which variable, you might ask? Well, let's go back to the home screen and to the invisible code. Let's add a first line, and that is going to be a set for a global variable, var loading dot true, and at the end, set var loading comma false. So what this does, really simple, and we can even add it in comments, show loading overlay, because this is the exact variable that we're going to use to trigger the visibility of our overlay. This is of course height loading overlay, and in between we have our data refresh code. And the final thing, of course, to do is to select this variable, go back to our group, to the visible property, and it's not going to be true or false. We are going to replace this by saying var loading. And I know I don't have a lot of data, so it might be just a blink that you see that loading overlay, but pay attention because I'm going to go to preview mode. I'm going to go to another screen and go back to my home screen, which will trigger the invisible property. There we go. There's the overlay. Boom, data is loaded and the overlay disappears. And the reason I chose a global variable is because this is a thing that I tend to copy paste into my other screens as well. So let's do that. So let's copy this entire formula to our invisible, for example, of our new order screen. Paste, And of course, let's take the group that we created, copy, paste to our new order screen. Let's rename everything and the group itself. There we go. And of course, the final thing that we could do is change this data refresh code. Is it necessary on this new order screen? I'm gonna leave it for now, but should there be other code that we want to run in between those two set statements, it's perfectly fine to just replace this code with whatever you want. And that's it. That's all it takes to create an overlay and to copy it to other screens as well. I bet that was way more easier than you thought, right? But if you have any questions whatsoever on the topic, use the comment section, or if you have ever implemented an overlay in your own app for whatever business case, let us know down there. That being said, let's move on to pop-ups. Pop-ups are another thing we all know. We have all seen it. You're visiting a website or an app on your phone, and all of a sudden something pops up that might look like another screen. Well, while that can be the case, depending on how it's developed, of course, pop-ups in Powerapps can be created without the need of a separate screen or whatever. Let me show you. And in all honesty, it is very similar to the thing we just did with the overlay, because we are going to add a bunch of controls to our new order screen, group them together, and then once again use a variable to determine the visibility of the entire group all at once. And let's start with that variable, because in the onSelect property of my confirm order button, which is still on the default value of false, I'm gonna delete that. This is where I'm gonna enable, if you will, the pop-up by saying update context, so it's a local variable this time, because we will only need it on this very screen and not throughout the entire app. And we're going to set the value for that variable to true whenever this button is clicked. And the next step is just to add a bunch of controls to this screen, and that in total will be our pop-up. But I'm not going to show you every little step that I do. So let's go. 3, 2, 1, boom. So this is all the stuff that I added. It's not rocket science, really. I just added two labels, these two. I added a vertical gallery to show the shopping basket items. I added a form right here, but I didn't do anything with it. I haven't even connected it to any data, because that is stuff for the next video. And I added two buttons, keep shopping and finish order. And I almost forgot to mention it, in the background, I have added two simple rectangles once again. The white one right here is the exact same one that I used in the overlay earlier. And the gray one is also just a simple rectangle with a border to kind of give that pop-up look. And the main thing, of course, now is to group them again. So I selected them already by holding down the control key, right click, group. I'm gonna rename the group to group confirmation pop-up underscore NOS. Because that is exactly what this is. This is our confirmation pop-up. And two things are needed to finish up our logic behind the visibility thing. First thing is on this button, keep shopping, which is basically a sort of cancel button. So in the onSelect property of this very button, I'm going to delete the default value false. I'm going to copy that formula that I used earlier to set that local variable to true. But of course, in this case, I want to set it back to false, because that eventually will hide the entire pop-up. And that is the very thing we have to make sure that we do now. I select the group, go to the visible property instead of the default value that is true. I'm gonna say var show confirmation, and immediately you can see that the entire pop-up disappears, because at this stage that variable is even blank, which is kind of the same thing as false. Hell, it's not true, that's for sure. But now we can actually test what we have built. So let's go to our preview mode. Clear our shopping basket, and you know what? Let's start at the home screen. There's our loading overlay, which is good. Let's go to the new order screen. And now let's add a couple of, you know what? Let's add some paper to our shopping basket. Confirm order, that triggers the visibility of our pop-up. We can delete stuff. I'm gonna show you in a minute what I did here, by the way, this cancel icon. But we can delete our items if we want to, and we can click the keep shopping button to hide the pop-up. And as promised, for those of you who might be following along by creating this own app yourself, this is the code that I had behind my cancel icon, which is basically very logic if you think about it. When we cancel an icon in our shopping basket, we want to A, do a -1 for our var local item counter, which is a local variable we created. We want to deduct the price of that item of our total price, which you can see right here, the 3. And of course, we want to remove that item from our collection called Call Shopping Basket, which this gallery is simply showing to the user. All in all, mission succeeded if you ask me. We have created an overlay and we have created a beautiful confirmation pop-up. Job well done. There is one thing that I almost forgot to mention, and it's important. Always keep an eye out on the order of groups and controls in your tree view. Because in our case, we want our loading overlay, so this group loading NOS right here, to be the absolute top layer of visibility. And that means it also has to be on top in the tree view, because the top element in the tree view is kind of like the first layer as far as visibility goes. And luckily, you can very easily solve issues like this by clicking the three dots of this group, for example, reorder, bring to front, and there you go. In the next episode, we are going to complete our app by finishing that form we already put in our confirmation pop-up. And of course, we will implement the necessary code and logic to make sure that if we actually finish or confirm an order, that our data also gets saved on SharePoint. That is my main goal for the next and last video in this series. But for today, I want to say thank you for watching. If you have any comments or questions, whatever, use the comment section. And don't forget to like the videos and subscribe to the channel. That is all for me today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next one. Take care.